Welcome to ReTrack 2.0 overview. The biggest new feature is the auto rebuild tool. Let's start from it. In this shot, I tracked two masks and I also tracked two points until the screen ran out of frame. The idea is to use the mask's data to rebuild the missing motion of the tracker points. So I select all the elements and I click on the auto rebuild tool. Because the motion tape is linear, which means horizontal or vertical, I choose the simple position option. As you see, the tracker points keyframes have been rebuilt and they work fine. Okay, now I select all the tracked data and let's retrack. In version 2.0, there are new options built to improve the retracking experience. I'm gonna draw a rough mask first. Select so the mask is loaded. I'm able to change the point's size, the point's color, and the mask color, white, and the mask size, of course, and also the background opacity. Well, I select only the four points I need and retrack. It looks like it works fine. So I click on Done and let's set the corner pin effect. To finish the job, I enter the corner pin's comp and I can text hello. Let's make it bigger. And hello. Here, same out of frame problem. I can't track off screen, so I select the four corners tracks and rebuild. I choose the perspective method because the motion tape is not linear. Well, it is recovered, but the motion estimation is not good enough. Why? Let's undo and add a fifth tracked point to the selection. As you see, these three points are almost completely tracked, so ReTrack can use a real triangulation and it can estimate the missing data in a much more consistent way. I select the fifth track and rebuild. Now the tracks match true to reality. I jump to the comp panel. Let's add the corner pin to the screen. As the points are exactly where I intend to draw the helper mask, I can use the convert tool. When I click on the choose button, the tracked points are activated. I can choose the points I want to convert to mask, or if I don't, all the points will be converted. Convert. The tracked mask is generated, and I can now set the corner pin from the drop menu. Let's work on the screen content. I'm gonna remove the checkerboard and set a gradient ramp. Get back to the phone and make the hand visible by adding key light to remove the green. Here, the hands block the tracking process, so I have to rebuild the missing keys. I select the tracker and I choose a perspective rebuild. The tracks are fine, but what if I wanted to perfectly align the track 1? I can use the new edit tool. It looks like it is the same as before, but it is not. In fact, I decided to rebuild it to make it more flexible. First, it gets the missing keys interval generated by the rebuild tool. So, if I need to refine the tracking, I know where to edit precisely. Something like that. Let's close it. In version 1, the edit tool was time-based. Now it is keyframes-based. So, it will work also when I move the layer in the timeline, and also if it is trimmed. Let's edit again. The virtual keys are where they should be. And I edit them the way I like. The new edit tool is not compatible with tracked items edited with ReTrack 1. I track this mask in perspective mode, forward. As we know, the number of vertices change over time. Now track backward. Vertices number change again. Of course, I just need the starting mask vertices. ReTrack 1.0 wasn't able to handle that. But now, if I try with 2.0, the script detects the mask vertices variation, and when I confirm it is a perspective tracked mask, it will get only the reference vertices all over the tracking. And the retracking process can go on. If I try with the edit tool, it's the same. Version 1.0 could not handle that, but the new version can. After the confirmation, it alerts me the mask has to be converted to Roto Bezier in order to proceed. The mask is reduced and converted, and I can edit the point as usual. When I use ReTrack with 3D tracking data, I enable a new option. Let's choose some 3D tracks and generate camera and solids. I'm gonna scale the solids and also rotate by 90 degrees to make them visible. To let you understand what's going on, I switch to two views. As you see from the top view, the active camera moves. And four solids don't. So let's select the 3D solids and ReTrack. I'm gonna choose and convert all the solids, so no selection. Of course, I choose the 3D nulls output. What happens is ReTrack freezes the camera motion and makes the 3D nulls move into the 3D world. Sorry, the new AI 3D axis lag is a nightmare. Let's hope Adobe fix it soon. How can I use the 3D moving nulls? Well, for example, they can generate particles. I will use this null. I already prepared a particle effect on this layer. I only have to copy and paste the 3D null name into the particle effect position expression, X, Y, and Z. So the particle system source is now linked to the 3D null. Let me hide the unused layers. Cool, right? Well, that's all. Let me know what you think in the comments. Cheers!